Good afternoon, everyone. I am Hafiz Zidani from Mohammedia School of Engineers, Morocco. I am pleased to share with you our research on multi-objective optimization entitled Variational Approach for the Determination of Continuous Pareto Frontier for Multi-Objective Problem. After an introduction, I will present the multi-objective optimization problem formulation and the current dominance relationships. Then the basic idea of our approach with a new definition of Pareto frontier. Then the new VAMO formulation and an experimental validation to demonstrate the efficiency of this method are presented, followed by a conclusion. Multi-objective optimization problems are common in engineering design. In this field, we might be brought to some of the hardest optimization problems which arise in many real-world applications. There exist a lot of methods intended to solve this class of problems, most of which use an iterative process to generate a set of points approximating the Pareto's front either in a singular simulation run or by transforming the multi-objective problems into a series of single optimization problems. Only simple case where the optimal Pareto set can be determined analytically. In general, we are satisfied with getting enough optimal Pareto points to cover the entire Pareto curve. The quality of the solution can be judged by its ability to cover this set in a uniform way, like in BI and in C. In some problems, the cost of producing a single Pareto optimum can become so great that the designer can only afford a few optimal Pareto solutions. The proposed VAMO has the advantage of generating enough points to represent the Pareto curve, starting with the most representative points. In all these approaches, we are interested in the approximation of the Pareto's front by generating a finite set of Pareto non-dominated points, giving an accurate representation of the Pareto's front, what generally supposes a large number of points. The quality of the results is evaluated by their ability to generate an evenly distributed curve. Thus, a suitable strategy must be adopted to avoid prohibitive computational costs. In this paper, a novel approach called Variational Approach for Multi-Objective Optimization, VAMO, is presented to generate Pareto points to represent the Pareto front with a good quality. In general, a multi-objective problem consists of a vector-valued objective function to be minimized and of some equality and inequality constraint. We consider in this cycle a multi-objective optimization defined as follows. Since there are multiple objectives which may be conflicting, the problem admits only solution in the sense of Pareto pro-optimality. Pareto's optimality is based on the idea of dominance, which defines a partial ordering on the objective space. The Pareto optimality concept, which was first proposed by Edgeworth and Pareto, is formally defined as follows. VAMO introduces a new concept of dominance between curves, or in general manifolds, instead of dominance of points, so that we introduce the following definitions. For a bi-objective optimization problem, the Pareto's front becomes a curve and the area limited by the Pareto curve and the two axes F1 and F2 appears as minimal among all the possible curves formed by points of the Pareto space joining the idle points A and B. The solution to this problem using the VAMO method can be formulated as a variational calculus problem. For multi-objective problems with M functions, the VAMO formulation is as follows. To demonstrate the effectiveness and validity of this new method, two implementations have been proposed. The first one, based on a direct application of the approach, has the advantage of generating a sufficient number of points depending on the needs of the decision maker and the desired accuracy. This approach is valid only for convex problems. The second implementation consists in writing the decision variables as a polynomial function of a real and positive variable. It's valid for both convex and non-convex multi-objective problems. To illustrate the efficiency of the Weimar method, we will focus on the case of convex problems. We used an iterative procedure based on the calculation of the surface by the trapezoidal method. And for each iteration, we searched the suitable point that can best represent the Pareto curve, taking into account the earlier identified points. The first problem is a single variable problem. It's used to illustrate the Weimar method and show the progress of the Pareto front construction. Solving this problem leads to the Pareto front of the figure. We observe that the points generated are rather focused on the curvature of the Pareto front located between 0.07 and 0.4. By increasing the number of points of the Pareto curve, we obtain a more accurate curve with lower relative error. We notice that the quality of the Pareto curve is improved by increasing the number of points. An acceptable approximation of the Pareto curve is obtained as soon as the number of points is greater than 7. And the number of 30 points is enough to adequately represent the Pareto front. The graph which represents the evolution of the error, the relative error versus the required number of points, shows that the error decreases rapidly between 1 and 10 points. From 60 points, this error tends to 0. The results for this first example show that the Weimar method is effective for generating enough points to represent the Pareto front. Here, we propose a comparison of the Weimar method with methods which are widely used in multi-objective optimization in the field of engineering, namely the NNSC, NBI, NCGG2 methods. The results are presented in terms of CPU time in seconds and the number evaluation of the objective function. It is observed that the NCGA2 method is able to generate the Pareto front except for F2 greater than 6, with CPU time and number of function evaluation higher than those for the NBI and NNC methods. However, the Pareto points are not uniformly distributed. The results also show that the NBA and NNC methods generate a Pareto front evenly distributed. The NBA method is slow and costly in terms of the function evaluation than the NNC method. This is due to the equality constraints that consume a lot of CPU time. The quality of the Pareto front in the region corresponding to F1 located between 0.01 and 0.10 is not good enough, since 3 generated points are not sufficient to represent this part correctly. We also observe that a very significant improvement of the quality of the Pareto curve is obtained by using Weimar. Indeed, 17 points that represent the Pareto front are distributed optimally to cover this curve with a faster convergence than the other methods. The results are presented in terms of CPU time and the number of evaluation of the objective function. We observe that the NSGA2 method generates a Pareto solution located between the optimal Pareto front with CPU time and number of function evaluation higher than NBI method. The second implementation consists in writing the decision variable xi as a polynomial function of a variable. Solving the convex and the non-convex problems with Weimar, based on the second approach and using MATLAB Neldermeed toolbox with a dimension of 4 leads to the Pareto front of the figures. For both problems, the algorithm succeeded in producing the whole extent of the Pareto front. We observed that the points generated for the non-convex problem are rather focused and the curvature of the Pareto front. As a conclusion, we can say that the two proposed implementations give very satisfactory results and demonstrate the effectiveness of the approach adopted. The first implementation is valid only for convex problems, but can be improved by introducing penalty constraints to be able to reach the points of the non-convex area. For the second implementation, which is valid for convex and non-convex problems, the choice of the polynomial basis can be not adequate for certain problems. A sinusoidal or finite element basis can also be considered. Other forms of implementation can be implemented, for example, coupling with evolutionary multi-objective methods such as NSGA and SPAI2, which work with a population. These ideas and other might arise in further studies. Thank you for watching.